I'm glad today to present the roadmap and plans for the Secure Partition Manager on the ARM v8a systems. I'm Olivier Després, working in the open source software group at ARM. So there were a couple of presentations earlier. First, the trusted firmware project update from Matteo and Shibu, presenting the trusted firmware project overall, and the secure partition in Opti, presented by Miklos, for which the current presentation is a continuation. So the Miklos presentation was focusing on the pre-ARM v8.4 platforms, where Opti acts as a secure partition manager. And the current presentation will ARM v8.4 platform nodes implementing the secure EL2 to state. And I will enter into those details now. So as a brief agenda, as a recap, we'll see the current Trustzone architecture and the problem statement and challenges. Then a brief recap on the firmware framework for ARM v8a. Then we'll discuss the SPM architecture in this context and what is Affinium in this context. An update on the project, our upstream activity, and the way the testing is done. So this diagram must be known by many of you in this call. That's the current Trustzone architecture, where we represent the normal world on the left-hand side, the important pieces here. So in the secure world are the EL3 trusted firmware, the trusted OS, and trusted applications. In the normal world, like it can be Linux. And in this architecture, we highlight the trusted application ecosystem. How do we have and the foundation among multiple vendors? So about the trusted application ecosystem, what we mean here, and as you see the slide, the trusted applications running at secure EL0 are mainly trusted OS specific and linked to a TA library. And on the other side, in the normal world, the client application links to a client library, which is tied also to the trusted OS. So this makes it difficult for trusted application to be ported to other trusted OSs. So that's in a way an API and linkage problem. On the principle of least privilege, so the idea being that a component must be able to access only the resources that are necessary for its operation and nothing else. So if we look at this diagram, there is one main problem, which is the EL3 and SEL1 layers that share the same physical map and possibly some hardware resources like interrupts. and there is no isolation between the two exception levels. And in fact, the left-hand side box labeled normal world isolation also falls into this principle of least privilege problem, in the sense that we highlight here that the normal world is not protected from execution state and can alter the normal world part, like the hypervisor or the operating system in the normal world. There is also the notion of protecting IP sensitive software in the normal world, like machine learning algorithms. We would not want that the secure world is able to alter such contents. And then on the multiple vendors aspect, so usually when a platform is shipped, there can be multiple silicon or drivers provided by the silicon vendor that or even a silicon provider a full trust.
Excuse me, Olivier, I'm sorry. We're getting a lot of audio drops. Do you want me to try to share the slides for you and see if that helps?
Yes.
Okay, so let me share my screen. Let's see if it comes up. Do you see the slides?
Yes.
Okay.
So to complete, thanks, Vicky. to complete on this slide five, the multiple vendors, leads to fragmentation around trusted OSs. And more generally, there is a trust problem among the components in terms of isolating the components from each other. So here. So what we highlight here that as a solution we should provide standard APIs so that components can across boundaries using standard APIs, and this standard APIs permit to extract the vendor code from EL3 and isolate this code at lower exception levels. This also enables the ecosystem for delivering the various components to work together and those vendors also to use the same standard APIs. And as a second aspect to the proposed solution, that's isolating the components through hardware isolation. And I will talk about this in the next slide. So on slide six, we highlight the first part, which is standardization of the APIs among components. So to achieve this, the ARM architecture group released the firmware framework for ARMv8-A. So the intent is to harmonize normal world and secure endpoint communication. So in this specification, there are multiple concepts introduced, like partitions and then secure partitions and partition manager and secure partition manager, the notion of partition manifest, and also a description of the standard interfaces for setup of and discovery of partitions, the interaction between the partitions being made through message passing, and the APIs necessary for memory sharing. So on slide seven, that's how it's depicted in the context where we are able to enable virtualization in both worlds. So as we said, first standard APIs and second isolation through the hardware. So here you see multiple small boxes tagged as FFA that refer to the FFA standard APIs. And on the right-hand side, there is this new EL2 exception level in the secure side with this component called the Secure Partition Manager. And this is, in a way, mirroring the existing hypervisor exception level at NSEL2. So on the next slide, on slide 8, we show explicitly this secure partition manager requiring the hardware isolation brought by the ARMv8.4 secure EL2 feature. So this brings stage 2 isolation in the sense that so what we call here secure partitions are secure sandboxes or more generally virtual machines running in the secure world. So within secure partition, the isolation between the different applications is done through a secure stage one MMU and controlled by the trusted OS. And the different secure partitions themselves are isolated from each other through the stage two MMU controlled by the secure partition manager at SEL2. So from this aspect, the output of the EL1 from an hardware perspective is an NS intermediate physical address, non-secure intermediate physical address, or a secure intermediate physical address, depending on the MMU settings in the stage one mapping. So in addition to that, talking about hardware, there is also coming along the SMMU v3.2 specification, which brings secure stage 2 isolation at device level to isolate peripherals that can be mastered on the bus so that they have a virtual view of the system memory. So this is an IP which is controlled as well by the secure partition manager. And the intent is that a secure partition in the secure world can own such peripheral. So on the next slide, that's how the secure partition manager architecture is described from the specification. So just as a note, the specification is providing a lot of possible configurations, mostly to support migration from the pre-V8.4 platforms to the ARMv8.4 onwards platform. So this picture shows the possible configurations when the SPM component exists at SEL2. And more specifically, the implementation we are dealing with in this presentation is about the secure EL1 secure partition on the left-hand side, where there can be multiple secure EL1 secure partitions in the system. In the middle box, that's about secure partitions running at the AR32 exception level at EL0. And on the right-hand side, that's secure EL0 secure partitions. So that's it's called this way because in this model, the SPM uses the ARMv8.1 virtualization host extensions to avoid using an SCL1 exception level and handle the secure partition directly using the secure EL2 and 0 translation regime. But again, the main focus for our early releases is really the AR64 SCL1 secure partitions. So on the next slide, we introduce here Hafnium. So what is Hafnium? It's a legacy Google owned project which was adopted to the trustedfirmware.org along with others like TFA, TFM, Opti, Embed TLS. So that's now part of this consortium. This was transitioned earlier this year in May, June timeframe. It's totally open source development, so anyone can contribute. Reviews are public. And relicensed as a BSD3, there is a co-maintainer chip by Google and ARM. So the intent is to make Hafnium as the reference open source SCL2 firmware. And at the end of this those slides, you will find a backup slide describing what's the legacy of Hafnium. And how it was architected to isolate VMs, virtual machines, in the normal world. And so the intent of the project here is really focusing on the secure world part, so the so-called SPMC. So on the next slide, we show where we are with regards to the release of an SPM component in the secure world. So earlier this year, around the V2.3 release of TFA, we upstreamed the SPMD component, which is the split of the SPM architecture sitting at EL3. So that's a component which already exists in the upstream TFA project. And since then, we've worked on a number of topics that you see at the top. So I will mainly describe what we are currently working on and targeting the TFA V2.4 end of this year. So currently we are working mainly on memory sharing IBAs, so the fact that we can share buffers between the normal world and the secure world, between, for example, a normal world VM or OS kernel to a secure partition. And also about interrupt management, where in the secure world, we expect that physical interrupts are all trapped by the SCL2 layer. And so like for a regular trusted OS, normal world, non-secure interrupts are forwarded back to the non-secure side, and secure interrupts have an opportunity to be handled into secure partitions that declared such interrupts to be owned. On the next aspects, it will be about the SMMU V3.2 support that I mentioned earlier, about supporting secure EL0 only partitions, and most probably a support for AR32 secure partitions. So on the next slides, that's about the contents for the V2.4 release. About the SPMD component, I talked about this. Power management is about powering up cores and how the SPM behaves with the physical core powering on and off. There is a track around secure boot for secure partitions. So obviously secure partitions once on booting must be verified for authenticity and integrity. So there is a whole track in the TFA bootloaders to verify the secure partitions during the boot time. We released an SPM architecture document that you can find through the Read the Docs interface and the TFA hosting. We released a set of tests in the TFA test repository using bare metal secure partitions. We also demonstrate the support for multiple secure partitions running along. The graph is mostly important for the total merged patches, which is a bit more than 20 as we are end of September. So just to show that there is some upstream activity going on. On the next slide, I'm highlighting another end-to-end testing that we are doing to make sure that everything works as expected. So this is starting from a prototype that the ARM architecture group had released earlier this year. So we are working at upstreaming most of it through the Affinium upstream master branch. But here, this is the whole ecosystem in the sense that you have the kernel component in the normal world. And namely the Opti driver and an FFA driver, talking FFA through EL3, the SPMD, the SPMC, down to Opti as a secure partition. A note about Opti as a secure partition, this is pending sharing with the Linaro people who might and most probably are in this call. So this specific flavor of Opti is the one which can run on top of Affinium as a sandbox in an SCL1 partition. We also demonstrate through the TFA test the possibility to add platform drivers at SCL1, and also a demo on what we call SCL0 partition, which are still under the hood SCL1 partition, but where the SCL1 is just a thin shim layer bootstrapping and jumping into an SCL0 application secure service, typically implementing a very simple FFA message loop. The last slide just sums up this and highlights that the EL3 and SCL2 components part of the TCB, that's really what we want to make generic here through trustedfirmware.org. And also the testing part is upstream through trustedfirmware.org. I think we reached the end of the talk. There are resources, you can have a look. Don't hesitate to ask questions through the Slack channel and reach to me. And thank you for your participation.
Thank you, Olivier. I'm looking to see if we have any questions. Currently, we may have one coming in. I think we have time for one or two. We have one coming in on the Slack channel from Leif. Get the next piece to it. So I think we'll do one and then we'll you can continue the question and answer in the chat.
Sure. So yeah, Leif mentioned, is it possible to run Affinium as a secure SPM component? So yes, it is possible. I can help you on this.
Okay, great.